Now, it's getting dark, so do you want to brave the wild rapids, or would you prefer to sleep?
Oh, it makes no difference to me. I got a sword.
Yeah, I'm going to sleep.
Hello, everybody. This is Dark Fan, and welcome not back to my first ever episode. Surprise! Nobody guessed it. Hypermine! And I am here. Oh, dog, shut up. F5. I am here with the sneaky, wonderful Lapis Lauri. Oh,
F1. Hey, Dark Fan. How are you?
Hi. And Lauri is going to fill my inventory up with TNT, and we're going to go around the server and blow everything up.
Mm-hmm. Yep, that's the plan.
Or not.
Well, maybe not.
Oh, great. It's nighttime.
Oh, that's right. We have a cure for that. I have a cure for that.
Oh, that's right. You can. I could. This is my first lesson here, and I think.
Okay.
I come up here.
You can actually sleep on the bed, or you can stand on it.
Oh, leave bed. Look, I see. Leave bed. Okay.
Oh. Or you can stand on it, and then you use your mouse and text over the day-night command.
Day and clear. Look at that.
Yes. And that is one of the very few things.
Oh, there goes.
Yeah. Just for a minute. That's one of the very few things that we've implemented on a completely vanilla server, just because we're content production and we want
and
to
what
be.
What that does, folks, is it sends a little signal out, and things are outsourced to some third world country where somebody's at a keyboard and they do the commands based on what's selected. Yep.
They're incredibly well paid and available 24/7.
So yes. Vanilla Minecraft, and
are you
for
ready?
Those, well, yeah, I've been.
It's not gonna be easy.
I've been itching to get back into vanilla. I have, and for those wondering, this is not going to replace the non-existent videos I currently have on Castaways.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's in addition to. So
perfect.
I got some ideas for that as well, but we're not, just so everybody knows, we're not giving up on Castaways. This frees me to do other things because I've got certain goals and stuff set up for Castaways. So this is me, Dark Fan Unplugged.
Yeah. All right. Now, I know Unleashed. You had some self-imposed rules on Castaway. So are you going to try and do the same sort of thing here? Or are you just going to go free for all?
No. I'm letting it all hang out.
Nice. Well, congratulations. You've come to the right place.
So
speaking of hanging out, I'm going to give you some stew because you might get hungry in a little bit.
Yep.
And these extra fine boots that I stole from some zombie.
Hey, that works.
And this is, you can use this or frame it. This is your very first pick.
Oh,
and you'll have
gosh.
To see what that says.
Horseradish.
So it might have been horseradish hype. You don't know. It could be.
Check Twitter, folks.
Check the Twitters. Follow on Twitter. It's all good.
So we are at Natural Spawn or Spawn.
Yes, this is Natural Spawn, and this is where our iron farm is that Soap the Great has made for us and has done a tremendous job. So all your iron needs are here, and there is a dispenser out in front of the island, and then he's building another cool thing. I'm not a redstone expert. I don't know if you didn't know that, but it's true.
Oh, the rumors are true.
At the redstone. I hire all that out.
It's outsourced.
I'm handy with the checkbook. That's what we do. So you can retrieve all of your iron here if you wish it. And people do come over and block up some iron now and again.
Well, you know.
But he's making another cool thing over here to the side that's going to be much more elaborate and cool. But that's up for you to explore.
Yeah.
Now, I guess what I should show you where Hypermine Central is.
Yes. So let me just.
Yeah, I got a couple things here for you, too.
And three more.
Nice round number of sticks.
Oh,
you
perfect.
Can go punch a tree. Because I know how wonderful it is to kill your first tree on a server, but
hey,
if you need to make up a sword, that might be recommended. Because
that's what
while
I just
we're traveling,
did.
You may not sleep.
I got a pocket full of iron, and I made some armor that I will put on later, and I made me a sword. So
awesome.
You're set. And I
All right. So the whole idea of Hypermine is when they instituted the unbreakable boats, we were like, yay, unbreakable boats. We're going to do everything by water travel. So the whole base was kind of set up as like a port and different things so you can get to places by water. Uh-huh. But we have an enormous rail system that's going into that our friend Basket MC is doing. But I can't remember. Is it? I just call him Basket. But we can get over there via this little rail line area. But you could also just follow this coastline of water and get to the Hypermine Central.
Whoa, that's the first time I've used Depth Strider. That was fast.
It's amazing, isn't it? Yeah, those are quite literally fresh off a zombie, so they might still have a bit of the guy left in there. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Super special little stuff.
They're a little stanky. I'm used to that,
just
though.
A little. Yeah,
call
them stanky legs.
Series.
Tie right in. Tie right in there. So, yeah, this rail line will take you there, and there's a road that we're going to build up to go to the iron farm as soon as Soap's ready to do all that. But it's kind of in the works.
I'm assuming Basket, this isn't a chunk air that I'm seeing here.
No. He has dug all this out. He's like crazy with it. And this is going to be some enormous rail switch thing. I don't even want to know. It's just cool.
I think it needs to be filled up with water.
I don't know about that. Maybe you can talk Maybe to not. Basket. You can talk to Basket about it.
It's not I'm a sure swimming hole, be... Dark Fan.
Well, there might be a few of those around. A few of those. So there's a little bit of a road system happening in and around Hypermine Port. So it's all over here. And this has all been done by Basket. I think it's Basket YT, Basket YouTube, not MC.
There'll be links down below.
Yep. I usually just send everybody to the Hypermine Reddit.
The subreddit. That'll work better. A link to the Reddit.
Yeah, and it's just everybody's listed there, so it's all good. Oh, speaking of, I'll have to put you on the list now that you're official.
Ooh.
Officially
squid,
official.
Squid making a squiddy sound. We'll Although I heard that. So the wonderful music.
I'm concerned.
Wait, is there a train coming?
Oh, it is. It's a train warning signal. That's cool. How do we check this out?
We're the only ones on. Uh-oh.
Oh, the button's not working.
Maybe he's right, just setting it up. Basket.
He's like,
nope, right?
You can't. Okay. He's not. He's not. I'm totally going to cheat and get over the top. Yeah, it's set up for a piston, I can tell. That is cool that he's got a noisemaker thing. No, it doesn't do anything. Oh!
There we go.
I wonder if it's on a timer that after the lights go off, the things drop down.
That's
pretty
again.
Cool. Yeah, I think that's actually kind of cool. I didn't know he'd done that. Yeah, he's got the warning signal. Awesome sauce. I bet that's on a detector rail that goes. That's... Wow, my guys are great. I didn't know even know we'd built that.
Basket Station, Port Hypermine, this way.
Yeah. And so here we start getting into some of the cool stuff in town. Now, I don't know what you want to see if you just want to look at like some of the major things in town today. If you want to go everywhere, do you want to see where farms are?
Maybe some major stuff today and then.
Okay.
Twinkle's Church.
Yep. So there's a church over there with a giant graveyard, which is super scary.
Ooh, spooky.
Very spooky. Let's see. This is Brahimi's windmill, and he's got Viva La Barney thing on top.
And he's got a torch up there.
Mm-hmm. That was my gift to him. He didn't like torches everywhere, and I was like, well, you sure do like torches. It'll be fine. And so there's Viva La Barney thing, and this is the rail station that will be set up to do things eventually. I'm not familiar with the whole thing. Somebody has advertised their new witch farm shop, which is kind of cool. That's Soap. Soap is doing all of our like redstone farm things usually. Yeah. He's all over it. Nice. Let's have a look-see. And then we have Mizuma Games has a trading shop. If you want to trade some things, you can do that. If there's any, you can trade some stuff.
Hop in the chest. I need a book. Oh, there's only one of you, though. Never mind.
So I suppose if you have a stack of quartz and you need a diamond, you can trade it out however you want to do that. But usually it's a trade some things. So that's cool. You can trade up some things. So don't touch the pig. They're albinos.
They're like, oh, carrot.
carrot. They're all about it. So these are community sheep and cows that you can harvest and breed. Now, this particular area over here belongs to Albanackers, who built our town hall. It's pretty cool.
Very nice.
And so our only nether portal in town is inside the town hall on the second story. So it's up here. Up above there. Up there.
Sorry, I had to stop and take a screenshot.
Screenshot. It's all good. Selfie time. Selfie time. So you can get to the nether through here, and we're just trying to limit the amount of portals in the town areas. It would just be crazy if there was
yeah, 100 of them. Especially with being so close together. And
oh, yeah, absolutely. So we'll go to the nether after a little bit if you still want to go do that. Depends on how tired you are after your jaunt today.
Yep.
Okay. So this is the back of this. Now, there is a library over here that's the brick building. Mm-hmm. And
oh, there's Ghast! Uh-oh. Ah, sword ready.
Don't scare me. Oh, man, those things are horrible. Ghast scare me. So there's libraries if you want to do some trading of books. He does have a trading system set up. And I think one of them's like a rule book or something that tells you all about what to do, the thing up here.
Right.
It's like what's worth what and how you can trade and all that kind of good stuff. All the goodness. Benito knows everything about bees unmodded. He's our bee master.
Benito.
Yep. And then you have Ghast tiers. If you're brave enough to come over and trade for a Ghast tier on the Ghast house, you're welcome to do that. Over here on that little mountain is Teal Lone Wolf's kind of base right there. Uh-huh. Oh, I'm the birch house. Using the favorite birch wood that everyone loves.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with birch.
Oh, yeah. Now, it's getting dark, so do you want to brave the wild rapids, or would you prefer to sleep?
Oh, it makes no difference to me. I got a sword.
Yeah, I'm going to sleep.
We don't want creeper holes.
mostly, I just don't want to die. So there's a road that goes around behind here that has a lot of community farm that you're always welcome to use. And I'll show you a little bit more about that.
Oh, I see. So there's food. Chorus plants.
Oh, yeah. We have been to the end. We've already killed our dragon, at least one of them. So we might do another one later. Who knows? But there is sheep. And there's the veggie tables. And then there's cows. And the chorus plants and netherwort also. Ah. Speaking of, let's refill this netherwort.
I shouldn't steal from people's presents.
Oh, no, it's okay. It's all good. In fact, over here also is a elevator shaft that goes down to a skeleton farm. So if you ride over, there's a place for a stable over there. And you can come right in here. Now, have you ever used a woolly vader or are familiar with them?
Is it this here, this spot?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, normally there's a cart and you would just ride the cart down.
Okay. Making sure auto jump was off.
What you do now is you hit the button and hold your space bar.
Oh, woo.
Space bar.
Yeah, I got
and then
it.
You can just walk out.
Okay. I wasn't holding it at first. I was almost at the bottom when you said, hold your space bar.
I told Jan the shift and she died and I felt really bad.
Oh, ouch.
Yeah, she kind of holds it against me. It's true. So we have a book farm here. We have cows and the
you
reeds.
You can grow books? Oh.
Yes. It's organically grown books right here. And we have a nano farm. I use the little short one and there's a big one over here. It's up to you. Whatever you want to do. It doesn't really matter.
These good. They'll still work, huh?
Oh yeah, you just hold your little seed.
I guess it was just the time. I think it was just the timing. They keep breaking it between updates or something like that.
And it's okay that the water sits there. We don't care. And then I just put everything back over here so that I can feed up the cows. And then here's your source. If somebody happens to use everything, you can get one or two things here to get started.
Right.
A skelly grinder, if you want to use it. Here's the on-off switch. And there's an AFK room in here where you can hang out. Oh, hi.
Hi.
We're in the closet together.
Don't tell anybody.
All right, I won't. But you can watch them go by. Super exciting. Super fun. Now in 110, you have this nice cone effect, so you can use a sword and get like all of them at once.
Oh yeah, because it does the
It's like an area of damage instead of just attacking one. So that's pretty handy. We'll have a couple of those guys drop down. And usually in these Furnae, there's some steak, and I'm taking that. Yes, there's some. I'll split it with you. Do you want some steak?
Sure. Oh, there. Steak and carrots.
Mm, yep. It's like a man food.
It's almost a stew.
Almost. And there's an enchanting table over here, and all the stuff in this area
that
is freebies.
Laughed at that.
Was there a lift? A witch somewhere?
Yeah, right when I said that, I heard a. It sounds like
really?
It's Lois.
Maybe she is. I don't know. There is mining stuff over here, so she. Oh, I hear her. She may be up above. There's a ravine up above us here a little bit too, so there may be one or two of them. Nice. All right, so you can ride the elevator back up, or we can go down this way. Oh yes, get some XP. Stampies.
There we go. Four.
Did you get any good loot?
I'm level four now.
And there's freebies in here. If you want any of this stuff, arrows, bows, feel free. Help yourself. There's more cheaty armor from.
I need a butter
only
hat.
The finest sacrifices right there.
Well, I might as well have a whole butter suit, right?
Oh, be so gloriously coordinated. Yes.
There we go.
Well, I'm going to put mine back on then so I don't feel all vulnerable. Now, you can go out this way and you can go to my basement of my house. I was just strip mining and found the skeleton spawner and made it. We can take the elevator back up. Oh, she is right here. Where is she? Now I want to find her. Suddenly caving.
Oh, it's definitely above.
Oh, come look at this. It's like fate.
But see, that's not. I didn't find it though. So.
All right. Well, fine.
Oh man, you and your silk touch. I'm getting all kinds of stone. Yeah.
You can have all these stones. Now, mending is a glorious thing that has come out.
Yeah.
In this particular edition of Minecraft, which we're all in love with, and there's a very cool place to go repair your XP. It's called the Pig Farm.
Mm-hmm.
We'll go visit that here a little bit in the Nether. I just dug. Look, here's some diamonds. Boop, ba doop, 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 doop. I'm just gonna leave them there. I don't need them right now.
Yeah.
Somebody will be like, "Why is there a hole here?" Oh, diamonds.
Here, you know what?
Hmm.
There.
Shh. It'll be perfect.
Nobody will ever know.
Be top
until they
secret.
Watch the
That's
video.
Now, I do have some basic farm stuff over here. I got a little baby chicken farm. I have a melon farm, a super smelter that I just put lava buckets in. Have you seen this little technique where you smelt something and it uses the lava bucket and then it ejects the lava bucket instead of using it up? That was new for me.
Oh, yeah. It used to consume the bucket.
Mm-hmm. You got fruits over here, and then your high-tech cactus farm.
Wow.
So if you need any cactus for any reason, it's here. I decided I didn't want to make a giant cactus farm because nobody needs that much cactus ever.
Right.
And, so if you need green dye for anything, come get your cactus.
Yeah, because usually you're just going to dye your sheep and then shear the sheep.
Yeah. Whoops. Ooh, or if you need it for glass or something, too.
Yeah. Oh, that's true. That's true. I guess you can dye glass.
It's true. This was my tester for a return thing, and so it's just hanging out here. So we'll do the endless stairway up. Up and away. I keep thinking I need to check my fluid usage. Like, am I not drinking enough water like an unturned?
Oh,
I'm like,
yeah.
I'm running really fast, man. I'm not going to make it.
I'm going to be thirsty.
Yeah. Whee.
There we go. Little horsey. Headbanger.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, because you bonk your head whenever you go through stuff.
Every single time I whack my head. Yeah. All right, so from up here, we can kind of get a better look at a few things. So Valentine's on the hill right next to me. There's Twinkle's Church, the town hall, the railroad station, like between us and the Viva La Verde thing. And then there's Luna Baluna. Now, Luna Baluna is the daughter of Albanackers, and she's pretty young, but she's allowed to come on here and play with him, and we don't care.
Hey.
That's fine.
Oh, never mind. I was going to ask about a sign, but I'll ask you that later. Oh. I saw the sign up there that said build. And,
oh, with the brackets.
I
know what
that's, yeah. I think.
Mm-hmm. That's for our overviewer map that is super duper private, but you can screenshot it if you wanted to look at things. That's fine. So we will go out to the port again right out here, and we'll just kind of meander that way, and I'll show you some things on this side of town. We got Scotty Garbitas's house over here on the hill, and then he's got a Scotty hole underneath it, which is basically a hobbit hole. And Vance Crafter came on and built himself a little house and a tower, but he's not an active member. He just hangs out once in a while.
Right.
We got Soap's house, and this is the transport something services of something, but Condrick built this. If you've got a skeleton horse, you need some place to keep it. Feel free to use one of the stalls. There's a lot of them. Then we have town villagers. These are all free to trade with. So they might have some cool trades. They might be just crappy trades. You never know. At one time, the town of Port Hypermine was overrun with villagers, and they've all been exported now. Now, this particular hut...
Was there originally a village here or something? Or,
did they just kind of overbred? Yeah, we started breeding villagers. Now, in the hole, these are the most cherished villagers, kept completely safe and humanely.
Oh, yeah.
They offer the mending trades and an infinity trade.
Oh, I see. Infinity.
So if you can get a hold of him. He seems pretty low. I can't seem to even get close to him. Oh, you have to shift. Okay. See, and somebody's borked the trade on this one because they didn't finish it out. So we'll have to come back and bring the good things in.
You got to do all of them now, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Just... So here's a melon tower if you need melons. Oh, not a bit of lag there.
It just collected everything.
Yeah. And this building off to the right is where the villagers seem to have congregated, which is crazy. This is the Whacked Mole, the public pub house.
The Whacked Mole.
And so these villagers are just out of control in here. They're all willy-nilly. They're drinkers, everyone. Way too social.
Man,
they're
just
bellied up to the bar.
Out everywhere.
Yeah, willy-nilly. So if you wanted to trade something, you could put it here. There's also an enchanting setup and more anvils than you can shake a stick at.
Well, I don't know. I've seen more.
Oh, yeah. I've seen a few of those myself. And there is kind of a public mine that you can go down and do, but I don't know how tapped out that is.
Right.
There's a few beds here. If you need some place to have a sleepy, you can do that and claim one for yourself. But I end up just keeping one on me all the time for emergencies such as this. Those poor villagers are like, we never get to sleep.
The dark clouds.
Yep. This is a public tree farm. Whew. All right. Yeah. Now let's take a breather. Let's go along the port. So this is where the original historical build was, this boardwalk, which is pretty nice. We've got a fish shop. Baskets fish shop. Our friend Nemson built this glorious lighthouse and watches over the bay for us, for wayward travelers.
And it probably lights up at nighttime if it was ever nighttime.
I think it actually does. And then Ektorvink
has redstone lamps up there. So.
Mm-hmm. Ektorvink has a glorious ship out in the bay ready to go do some trading or pirating. I'm not sure which.
The one with that ship with the pumpkin on it? Oh, that's a buoy. That's a buoy.
Yeah. Look over that way to the right.
Wait.
That's a big ship.
Lord it for something else.
Oh, okay. Oh,
let's bump that up a bit.
So he's got a big ship out there.
Oh, there we go. Oh, that's a little bit. It's like I see a little boat out there. It's like,
You're like, that's not as impressive as I thought.
I can build one of those too with five planks.
Yeah, totally. And there is a Ektor's home by the sea. So Ektorvink, the shipwright, he lives here. Mm-hmm. Let's see. And then I think there's the port authority. Benito Shackside. See, he did have the port authority in here. He was the one you'd have to ask about things to go.
I don't think I've ever
shopped
at port authority.
No, really? And so if you wanted to do buoy bases and have a waterway, the whole idea was to start building buoys where the base was a color that said, okay, follow these to go wherever, or and mine would be blue. You know, you can feel free to pick one. And sadly, someone's already chosen the black one. Boo. Maybe you can make some arrangements with Jen to alter that. She's the one out there with the Guardian Temple. So that's pretty much town, everything that goes on here. And you're free to explore and see some other little things. Voodoo Beard's got a little place up there. They've got a trading shop along the boardwalk. So, yeah. And then Run Wild's got a house here at the end of the bay on the other side. If you're looking for some place to settle, almost any place in town or on the outskirts of town is probably fair game. Any place past my birch house is open. Or any place along the bay that you can get to. The only thing I would say is don't get too close to the natural spawn with doors and things. He's got like a, what am I trying to say? Netherrack. Yes, that's the word. Oh. They have netherrack on the ground that says don't build past this point so the doors don't affect the village.
Right. Yeah. So why don't the seagulls fly over the bay?
I don't know.
Because then they'd be bagels.
Oh, they would be delicious too. I would toast them. Toast them with some schmear. Would be great. Yeah. Now, do you want to see where some of the other farms are and grinders and things like that?
Maybe? Yeah, let's take a look at that.
All right, so, let's head through the nether. Let's go to
the
nether. Let's go to the nether. Where Dark Fan will die. Dun, dun,
hey,
dun, dun,
I won't
dun.
Die.
Hey, you work. Might. Oh, okay. Just don't high-five the pigman, please. There's only one place we can escape to, and even then it might not be safe.
Not without enderpearls.
All right. This is the nether hub area. I've cleared it, and I started working on tunnels. I haven't got any beautifications on the walls yet. All right. Let's see where to go first. Let's go to the pig farm. It's right here. Up and away. So Teal Lone Wolf figured out how to break through the bedrock in 1.9 or 1.10 because you weren't able to when that update came. And it was like pistons like, and TNT and I don't know what all, but it was crazy.
Yeah, he hit the ender pearl up to the top and used pistons and TNT and some weird stuff.
Hop in the cart and push the button.
Hop in? Stand in or do I actually get in it like this?
Just, right click to get in, just keep riding. And then, just like you would get off a horse or anything, just shift to get out of the cart when you're at the top.
Yep, I'm out.
And then you can push the button and send it down for me. Please.
It's on
its way
down.
Climb the ladder, but I'd be here for days.
Flesh trading station?
Don't ask.
Oh, I see.
It's all perfectly legit and safe.
Yep.
Those flesh traders are inspected monthly.
That was funny. You popped up higher than the minecart. You were still sitting when you went.
Oh, really? It tossed me right up there. So if you wanted to do any kind of like a mending repair or XP repair, you just take a bow, and there's usually one up here that you can use if you don't have one. And then you just anger a pigman.
And then they just run
just stand there.
And try to get to you. And
they fall down. Yep, that's all. It's all good. It's magical.
Yeah, and I remember you were saying that there was an issue with some infestation. Oh, there's some Endermans and the slimes.
Yeah, no, they do spawn. Spawn Endermen and the magma cubes and regular villagers now. So the only thing with the Endermen is that sometimes you'll be staring out into space and you might upset one.
Yep.
And they tend to greet you at the bottom of the elevator. So I'm going to have to make a safety chute from the elevator out to the exit.
Right.
There's a guy here you can trade the rotten flesh with. There's a bunch of it. You can get gold here. You can brick up gold if you want to. It's okay with me. There's a bunch of freebie stuff over here, books and things. And we haven't got a book sorting system yet. And more gold swords than anything ever. We just need to throw them out because no one will ever use them. Ooh, this guy's got a mending enchant too, but he takes 26 emeralds. That's a lot, yeah. Oh. It's golden, yeah. So yeah, this is a complete thing. So if you wanted to ride back down, I would let you know. I'll be down there too in just a minute. Bye.
Oh dear.
Oh dear.
And am I down? Okay, and then send it back up for you, right?
You can, or I can just drop it. Doesn't matter.
I did.
I'll wait.
It's on its way up.
Say, now that you've pushed it, I'm not going to go down in the middle of it, or it's all going to be wrong.
Somebody will have to climb the ladder.
That'd be me. You got to put a rail on the top of that half slab and put the cart back in to seat it properly, or it never works right again. Boink. Yay! So that's the pig farm. Teal Lone Wolf built that for us.
Very nice.
Okay. Now for the fun times. Let's see. We have a mesa and a desert. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We have a guardian farm. We have a blaze farm. I have a witch farm. I don't know if there is a portal to the witch farm yet. There might be. So any of those interest you, or all of them, or how you want to work it?
Surprise me.
Surprise. All right, let's go this way. Hopefully there's a cart. Bye.
There we go.
That's what my rail was in my basement. I was testing that return.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Now, Brahimic is a gentleman who pretty much streams from midnight till 7 in the morning, like every single day. And right. He came on and built all this for us, and then he went back to work in some mod packs that he likes to do, and he comes back onto vanilla once in a while. This is supposed to go to the blaze farm. I'm wondering if we've gone too far. I feel like we have. I think we've gone way too far, because I think this actually goes to Brahimix. Hang on. I'm going to hop out.
See you later, Kurt.
I'm just going to let that roll. Yeah, I totally have gone too far. I'm sorry. I should have went down there and came back. But...
Well, it's a good thing I got that steak.
It's a 40 steak tunnel. It'll be fine. This is just tall enough that it doesn't work for the super fast hopping.
Yeah.
But there's a blaze farm that I was going to show you. Apparently, it has detoured off. There used to be a turnoff to the right. Did we pass it? Maybe I missed it. But it's not nearly this far. Run, my cat body, run.
There we go. I need some steak.
Me too.
It's almost a awkward feeling run, sprint, jump thing.
Yeah. It's easier to go on the rail. Oh, geez. We could have just walked down here. Look, here's this stupid
thing. Is it right by the...
Yes. Derp de derp. Brilliant.
That's probably why the cart doesn't go to it.
Okay. So, yeah, we can get into this cart and go, and it goes much faster.
Oh.
Whee. And this is how I get to the bottom of the nether as well. Ooh, carrots. Delicious. I hear the pig man.
Oh, yeah. I hear him over there.
So I come down here to get any lava that I need. There's like a giant pool of lava underneath the blaze farm.
Yeah.
And if I need to go, I don't know, adventure out and be scared, this is pretty much where I go. Because the nether is terrifying. It's dark and full of nether.
Oh, and I probably need to break that. Wait. Oh, there goes that card.
Yeah, it'll be right. So this is the blaze farm, and it does work. You can turn it on and off. This is the squeezer. And they do just naturally kind of spawn here. I don't think there's an on-off switch. Not that I'm aware of. There's a killer, and then there's a turn it offer type thing. And there's an... all this up here with all the enchants. So this
is
all pretty.
I recognize this style of blaze farm.
Top notch. Mm-hmm. This is a top notch blaze farm. So here it is in all its glory. So they'll step on the little pressure plates and things happen. The miraculous things. The Castier shop. Everybody's got their posters up everywhere. It's funny. So this ladder leads down below, which goes to Pigman.
A super safe area.
Mm-hmm. This is the floor of the Nether. Now, there's other ways to get here, but this is just the best way for me because I know that I have lava exactly where I need to. Because I use it for fuel. And then if I need to go exploring out into the wilderness, that's where I go. Looking for glowstone or quartz or whatever.
There's a 2-block deep hole just right there in the floor.
Like a, is there a pigman in it?
No, you just walk around and all of a sudden,
you're like, I'm going to go to, oh, nice. They're going to end up in the lava pit, maybe. There. Perfect.
Smack.
That would be scary, really. Yeah. Don't find, no. Don't high five them. That'd be buying, okay. So yeah, there's the Blaze Farm. It's pretty cool.
All right, folks, we're going to cut it here. We've been having so much fun. Time's been flying by. And I really, really wanted to get this out to you. I'm super, super excited to be a part of Hypermine. Huge, huge thanks to Lapis Lauri and everybody else. Be sure to check the subreddit. I'll have the link below for all the other members. On Hypermine. And next time, we'll continue our tour with Lauri. And until then, we'll see you guys later. Bye! Bye, 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 bye. See you later. Bye!